we're going to compare the BeQuiet Dark Rock Pro 4 to the Noctua NH-D15 CPU coolers. Before we begin, let's open up the packages. The slowed versions of the unboxing can be found in the description below. Next, let's look at some key metrics. Both CPU cooler images shown on the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, both coolers may have RAM clearance issues depending on your setup. Additionally, they both extend out on the back side, which may cause clearance issues with micro motherboards. Both coolers have two fans, with the D15 using two 150mm fans, while the Dark Rock Pro uses a 120mm fan and 135mm fan. It is possible to add additional fans to the NH-D15, but adding additional fans may cause clearance issues depending on your setup. In regards to installation, the Noctua is much easier to install. However, the Dark Rock Pro 4 is much easier to uninstall and allows you to slide the radiator off the CPU while the Noctua does not. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the fan's performance using over 1 million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the Dark Rock Pro in red to the NH-D15 in blue, we see that they perform the same across the board at idle temperatures. Given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see that the D15 has better cooling performance across the board, with that difference shrinking to minimal levels at approximately 100% fan speed. When considering noise, the NH-D15 does not make noise above ambient levels until around 55% fan speed, while the Dark Rock Pro doesn't make noise until approximately 65% fan speed. Overall, the Dark Rock Pro is quieter across the board. Next, we will look at the CPU overclock to 125 watts. This shows that the NH-D15 can handle overclock temps better than the Dark Rock Pro. Next, we will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis while keeping temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the coolers by normalized noise levels, we see that they perform the same across the board at idle temperatures for a given noise level. However, as we increase the wattage to 105 watts, we can see that the NH-D15 performs slightly better for a given noise level. This trend continues as we move to 125 watts. Overall, both CPU coolers have similar cooling performance at idle temperatures. However, the NH-D15 performs better as we increase the watts, driven by higher airflow, coupled with a slightly larger radiator size, making this cooler the winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.